Right, we are here in Chandigarh for the NDTV 40s More to Give campaign, and I have with me a former hockey Olympian, a legend of sorts whose record has stood for 62 years. He's won 3 gold medals for India, Balbir Singh. We also have Dr. Mukut Mins, who's the head of organ transplants of Fortis, and Dr. G.D. Puri, the acting director of PGI Chandigarh. I'll start with Balbir Singh. Sir, when a person like you come and, you know, ask people to donate organs, does that, you know, bring about a greater emphasis?
Before asking people, I offer my organs. It's a great honor to offer organs that this may be of use to some others after your death. It's very good, and I congratulate the organizers for organizing this function. I would request and suggest all of you to offer organs. May your organs be of some use to others in the country. And it's very, very important function. I really congratulate you for doing this. This is an important function.
Right. Okay. Each one of us can save at least 8 people. Dr. Mins, has a campaign like this made any difference? This is the second year of the campaign.
Yes, it certainly has made difference, and it has to make a difference. And I can see the enthusiasm in the children and old and everybody. So it is making a difference, and it has made a difference. What we have seen in PGI, in this tri-city, it has made a difference, and the number of organ donation is going up, and the results, the outcome of transplant from cadaver donor transplant, it's really good. There's no doubt about it.
Sir, we know in cities there is a greater presence, and the people in cities know a lot more about organ donation. But what about rural India? Would you say that is a part that's neglected?
Well, yes, awareness among the all strata of the people is required, and that's what the government has made a national organ tissue and transplant organization, which is doing a great work in this regard. And the regional center is at PGI Chandigarh, headed by Dr. Vivek Vipin Kaushal. And the results for the last 2 years is that more than 26 people donated last year, and this year more than 40 we have already donated. There is a long waiting list. There's about more than 5,000 people waiting for donations. Unfortunately, we are not getting, and these like activities, the NGOs, involvement of the religious sabhas, the various local organizations. This is the work of the Roto. Roto is coordinating with the colleges, universities. They are organizing walks, marathon. These are the activities. Then they are involving the media, and that's the biggest part is played by the media, because that brings everybody together on one platform.
Altruism is a part. Let me take this question to you. Altruism is a part of the Indian society, but would you say that the biggest challenge is in the whole structure and there not being a proper system for donation?
It's a very good idea. You are doing an excellent job. Continue doing it every year, every month. It's so important. I give very great importance to this function and to the organ donations.
So,
go ahead.
As a doctor, do you face this as a challenge? If the system was more structured, it would have been easier for you to conduct this.
Well, it is getting organized, I would say. What it used to be some 20 years ago, things have changed. And awareness is a continuous process. I have seen overseas also. It's not one day, you do a program and the people are sensitized. No, it is not like that. Every now and then you have to keep on reminding the people that this is the need, and this is something that we should do for our own fellow citizens.
Also, there are many donors who come from other countries, who come from abroad to India. Can they jump the queue, or do they also have to be in the queue as the other Indians?
You mean recipients?
Yes.
Well, no, I don't think they have a very solid structured program of the Roto Noto. They have whenever there's organs available, this matched with the compatible blood group, and first preference goes to the center which is donating, and then to the region, and then to the nation. And if the recipient has already been registered with some hospital, then of course there's a waiting list. So I don't think there's a possibility, but well, you cannot rule out all the problems which can creep in, but the government is doing all things to plug all the loopholes.
Would you say a lot of times the transplants are held up because there are so few transplant specialists in the country?
Yes, we have a sort of specialists, especially the surgeons, unfortunately, and I think the government and the society and the medical institutions, they will take care of it because of the need. Certainly we need more specialists, more surgeons, competent surgeons trained, because the government of India has already laid down the what should be the criteria of a surgeon to do to transplant. So this will happen, and we'll have enough number of surgeons, I'm sure.
Like, if the private sector is struggling, even the government would be struggling in this. Sir, one question to you. India probably faces the double whammy of having the maximum number of deaths in road accidents, yet not having that many donors to donate. Would you say that is where the system also needs to bridge somewhere?
Yeah. Every 4 minutes, somebody is dying on the road. He or she can be a prospective donor. And the government is trying to do the maximum. This is the first step. The regional centers are being made, and the media is helping to bring the awareness. There is as the myths needs to be broken with the help of religious leaders, with the help of the political leaders, and obviously the doctors are there to help all the time.
What is the biggest myth that you would like to break as a doctor? What is that one message that you are giving to the donors today through this campaign?
Donors, you mean donors' family or the will?
Yeah, donors' family. Because a lot of times we know when, you know, even after the donors die, the families are not very keen, on donation.
Well, again, things are changing. I'm pretty optimistic about it. I would say, as I mentioned, that what it used to be some 20 years, 25 years ago, is not the same. Now, many times I have seen myself that the family comes themselves. Now, they want to donate. Why it's getting late? So things are changing, and I'm sure it will change. But then, and of course, activities like this, awareness campaign, it will make a difference. It is making a difference. But India, we have many things. Not only transplant, we have got dengue. The other side, everything. So we have to fight out every possible human disease and things like that. So it is taking time. One step, it's going to make a difference.
Absolutely. And positivism is the word for today.
Yes.
And
yes.
We have all of you, all of you are today to flag off this walkathon, and let's do the needful. So here you can see the flag, the walkathon is being flagged off in Chandigarh by the dignitaries. We have a very, very eminent person among us today, Balbir Singh, who has won as many as 3 Olympic gold medals for India in hockey and has a record that has held for 62 years. No one has broken his goal scoring record. So he is the chief guest here who is flagging off the walkathon. And we also have G.D. Puri, who is the acting director of PGI Chandigarh, along with Dr. Mukut Mins. You can see all of them on the stage. Dr. Mins, in fact, is a national figure. He's a Padma Shri. And he is there on the stage flagging off the marathon. I'm sorry, it's a walkathon. It's a 1 kilometer walkathon, part of the More to Give campaign.